Hello everybody and welcome to a new Ergobits. This time around it's all about good news. We have shipped all the Dygma Raise 2 pre-orders and have everything in stock. We are testing the final beta version of the Defy 2.0 and Raise 2 1.2 firmware before the official release. We have also released several Bazecor updates focused on bug fixing. Finally, hundreds of you have completed our survey about what you want us to focus on in 2025. We'll share the results by the end of the video, so make sure to watch it till the end. Hi, I'm Michael Corby, and I'm thrilled to be bearing good news. Let's start with the most important one. By mid-January, we had manufactured and shipped all the Dygma Raise 2 keyboards. And now we have everything in stock. It has taken us a little bit more than planned. The goal was to have shipped everything by the end of November, but we are delighted with the quality of the keyboard. The Raise 2 reflects the premium build quality we envisioned, from the aluminum top panel to the magnetic pad pads and the tinting solution. If you want to get this fine piece of engineering, or its brother, the Dygma Defy, now is the time. We have everything in stock, and you can have it at home in 10 to 15 days. Last minute update, we have just added the option to select express shipping at checkout, so you can get your keyboard in 5 to 7 days. If you're from the US, don't think about it for too long. With the current trade wars, you never know when importing something from abroad will become more expensive. Price can go up. You never know. After weeks of testing and multiple beta releases, we are at beta 18 at the moment, we are really close to the official release of the Dygma Defy 2.0 firmware, which improves the overall connectivity of the keyboard in all modes and adds finer configuration options for homegrown modifiers. We've also been working on the Dygma Raise 2 1.2 firmware, we work a lot, which improves some inconsistencies while waking up the keyboard from deep sleep. It also gets rid of a bug where the keyboard would accidentally go into Bluetooth mode while wired, and fixes an issue where changes to the LED colors would not be applied until you power cycle the sides. If you want to try the beta, you can do so at dygma.com/defybeta or dygma.com/raise2beta, depending on your keyboard. You can also wait until the official release. You'll get notified on Bazecor when a firmware update is available. And talking about Bazecor, during the last few weeks, we've been bugfixing Bazecor like there's no tomorrow. We've been busy beavers. We've released Bazecor 1.6.2, 1.6.3, and 1.6.4 with several bug fixes regarding firmware flashing, adding a key on tap, LEDs, macros and super keys, the release notes, Bazecor on Linux, and much more. If you want to read all the release notes, check the link in the description below. Bazecor should auto-update to the latest version if you have that enabled in the preferences. But remember, you can also download it from dygma.com/bazecor. Finally, let's talk about what we have in store for 2025. Recently, we asked you for your opinion on what we should focus on during 2025 regarding Bazecor, the firmware, new products, and even content for this channel. And I must say, are you mind readers? Because we are pretty aligned.
Please don't read my mind.
For Bazecor, the most voted features by far were improve the way you configure and assign macros and superkeys, sync names of layers, macros and superkeys between computers, and have profiles that you can quickly load into the keyboard. I assure you that those three are on the roadmap for this year and in that order. Surprisingly, improving Bazecor over Bluetooth and making Bazecor online were among the less voted. For the firmware, the top three were extended battery life, more robust connectivity, and polish the super keys. And we can't agree more. The two first are our focus right now, and super keys are next. The less voted were having more than 10 layers and finer mouse key configuration. Regarding the content we make, such as videos, articles, or newsletters, you were pretty clear. You want ergonomic peripheral comparisons, ergonomic tutorials, Bazecor tutorials, and development stories. We'll definitely consider that for future content. You also expressed that you don't like podcasts and live streams. We already kind of deducted that based on how few of you watch those, but it's good to have an official confirmation.
It's official.
Finally, and probably the most popular, we ask you what you want us to make next. Here are the top requests. A vertical mouse, a trackball, add-ons for the Raise 2, and a low-profile columnar keyboard. Unfortunately, I can't reveal what we're currently working on. My boss would kill me. So you'll have to wait and see. So don't forget to like, subscribe, and hit the bell icon so you get notified when we announce it. And that's it. See you around in the following video. Great success!